Could you follow your car mechanic's instructions with 44 minutes of delay in communication when it comes to a hard task? Well, that delay is only one thing the first Martian colony will face, but certainly not the hardest. Join us in today's video as we reveal all those things that make Mars colonization a real suicide mission. Admittedly, scientists have made huge strides in space. Cosmic travel has become much more easy than it was some decades ago. We now have several spacecraft exploring different planets. We've managed to land both humans and machines on the moon, we successfully built the ISS, and we've been able to send two space probes outside the shores of our solar system. But on the flip side, things are not as rosy as they seem to be. For instance, we're barely able to sustain our existence on the ISS, even though it's only 230 miles away from Earth. And with all our claimed technological advancements, the farthest adventure by a human in space was landing on the moon, which was only 1.3 light seconds away. Yet scientists think we can go 1,000 times farther. The cosmic obstacle that exists between Earth and Mars are quite enormous, which makes it surprising that we're even thinking of colonizing the red planet in the first place. No matter how much we try to downplay it, the existing rocket technology is not yet efficient enough to take us to the Martian world. We haven't even been able to solve the rocket equation problems, which has been the biggest bane of the space industry. The rocket equation states that as payload mass increases, so does the amount of propellant required to escape Earth's gravitational grip. This means that the propellant of the rocket alone accounts for 60% of the rocket's weight. Even the Saturn V rocket used about 950,000 gallons of fuel to travel to the moon. Imagine how many gallons we'll need to complete the journey to Mars. There will literally be no space to carry other necessary supplies. Although rockets have gotten bigger and better over time, the technology behind rocket engines hasn't really improved since the days of Yuri Gagarin and Alan Shepard. Using the current rocket engine technology and the gravity of planetary bodies around, we'll need approximately 6 months to travel to Mars. And that's if we get all our calculations right. The best procedure would be to accelerate halfway to Mars and decelerate in the second half of our trip. This would cut our traveling time like crazy, but as we mentioned, we lack the necessary rocket engine technology. So as of today, space probes accelerate hard to escape Earth's gravity, and basically, they're just coasting from then on with their gained momentum. This is our best solution just yet, but that's just half a win, because Mars has an ultra-thin atmosphere, so it's very difficult to get rid of the spaceship's momentum and land on the surface. Even if you tried to land with a parachute like space capsules do here on Earth, you'd still fall too fast and eventually crash into the red planet's surface. Scientists have devised innovative ways of going around this problem. One of them is to use the small friction of the Martian air, deploy a parachute to slow down as much as possible, and then automatically inflate airbags to bounce off the probe's momentum. The other way is using a small rocket to slow down the space probe, like SpaceX's Falcon booster does. The latter is the only way to land safely. However, the amount of fuel needed for the action and the rocket equation problem doesn't allow us to do it. But not just that. By default, every space exploration project has a command center that provides support to the crew from Earth. Usually, the communication between the mission command and a crew in space happens in real time. Both sides can exchange different messages and walk through the trip and problems as they occur. But due to the distance between Earth and the red planet, the situation will be very different and much more complicated when it comes to this mission. Scientists estimate that it could take 22 minutes for Martian astronauts to send a single message to Earth, and then they have to wait another 22 minutes before they receive a reply. That means they need almost 1 hour to complete an end-to-end communication between Earth and Mars. Just picture that in your mind. What it would be like if a crew of astronauts on Mars ran into some life-threatening problems that must be solved within 10 minutes. How would they go about it? Imagine you would need to guide your car's mechanic or explain him a serious problem with 44 minutes of delay. It would be an extremely difficult task to carry out, but it would be nothing compared to the tasks needed to be done in a Mars mission. So it's quite clear that a never-before-used communication procedure must be worked out. But this is very far from reality as of today. Just like self-sufficiency. But to survive in the Martian world, we need most of the basic things that exist on Earth. Things like water, oxygen, and electricity. And to generate all of that on the red planet is a very difficult task. For sure, Martian astronauts could lean on some already mastered procedures thanks to astronauts on the ISS, like making oxygen and recycling water. But the Martian systems have to be 100% reliable, as there will be no escape plan if anything goes wrong. Besides being able to transport all of these systems to Mars, NASA must solve yet another big problem: food. Because of the big distance between Earth and Mars and the narrow launch window when a rocket could be sent to the red planet, no agency will be able to send enough supply ships to the first Mars colony. That means they will have to grow most of their food. And it is more complicated than you think. Many experiments on ISS show that it is possible to grow plants in space, but they are very far from being reliable enough to count on them. But first, NASA would need to figure out which plant they should grow to assure their astronauts' health. So it's clear that there is a long way to go in that sense too. But eventually, the success or failure of the mission will rest solely on the crew. They'll have to build every single piece of infrastructure. They need to be capable of construction things, be familiar with mechanics, electricity, and programming, cooking their own food, treating themselves if they fall sick, and do all the other stuff that humans need to survive the harsh environment of Mars. Basically, every astronaut on the trip will need to be a superhuman. But that might not be enough. When astronauts come home after a 5-month stay on the ISS, they are sick. They feel dizzy all the time, they throw up, and they cannot control their body very well. Even their skeleton is weaker, so are their muscles. No wonder they need weeks or months to fully adapt to life on Earth again. So after a 6-month trip to Mars, they might not be able to get out of the space capsule and do all the things they must. And NASA knows this. That's why dozens of experts are around astronauts after they return to Earth. They want to follow their recovery and learn as much as they can. However, if the Martian astronauts cannot leave their ships for weeks, then they'll need a very capable ship. One that is able to support and provide them with everything they need to stay alive. That spaceship design is yet to be invented. All the more as nobody knows at the moment what this ship must be capable of when it comes to protecting the astronauts. The red planet offers only 38% of the gravity of Earth, but suffers higher radiation and has no magnetic field to protect the first colony there. Nobody knows how these circumstances will affect the human body. Yet another big problem to solve. But not as big as coming home. Every astronaut who visits Mars will most likely wish to come home to their families. But it's not as easy as it sounds. The trip back to Earth will be just as difficult as the journey down to Mars, or perhaps even worse. Astronauts will have to generate their fuel in the required quantity that will be enough to return back to Earth. We are barely able to do that on Earth, even with the help of field experts and all the sophisticated science labs around. So it is very unlikely that astronauts alone will be able to do that on the go with less sophisticated science apparatuses. So we better not venture to Mars until we have the answers for these huge problems.